Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Hi folks, we are starting a completely new series on CodeTutor, and this series is going to be all about how to apply SOLID principles in case of an Android application. This series would be suited for people who already know Android application development, who already know composables, who already know the Android app architectures like MVC, MVP or MVVM. They know composables, they know how to work with room database, repository design pattern, view model, all those things. But they still feel that they need to learn how to apply SOLID principles along with these best practices which they might already know. So if you are in this category, then you are in the right place. This series is going to basically walk you through how to apply SOLID principles on an Android application that has been built with composables, MVVM architecture using room database and repository design pattern. If you are completely new to this, then what I suggest is you stop now and go back to the other tutorial series that I already have. If you want to know about Android app architectures like MVC, MVP, MVVM, go through this particular tutorial series. And then if you want to understand the composables, then I have another separate series. There is another separate series as far as the room database is concerned. So just go through all of them. Make sure that you understand, because in this tutorial series, I won't be able to walk you through all of those things. So once you are comfortable with those things, you can get started with this tutorial series. And of course, it will all be done using Kotlin, not Java. So having understood that, I will now start giving you a very quick walkthrough of the application that we already have built that we will be refactoring to make it comply with SOLID principles. So without much further ado, let's go through the application and the code. And if you have gone through the previous tutorial series on CodeTutor as part of composables or room database, you might be already familiar with this particular application. So let me run the application. So this is basically a scrollable list of countries information. And what basically happens is you can do a long click and it opens a dialog box, asks you to whether should I delete that particular entry or not. You can confirm, that will get deleted. If you do a double tap, then you can modify the name of the capital. So I can just say new capital sample and confirm, and that particular new capital sample gets applied to the entry that you had double tapped on. And then I have also added a couple of more features in this, which are filter features. This we had not done earlier in the previous demos, but I just wanted to make the application comprehensive enough. So I have added filter feature here. So you can basically filter by continent. You can click on this continent tab and say Asia, and you should be able to only see those entries which are in Asia continent. And then there is another option, which is drive side. And if you enter left, then it basically filters out and shows the countries which drive on the left side of the road. And if you just enter right, it shows those countries which drive on the right side of the road. May not be much useful of a filter, but this is good enough for the demonstration purpose. So this is our application. We have already built it using the MVVM architecture, using the room database. So this is for the uninitiated. I will now quickly walk you through the project application structure. So if you look at here, you have components, dialogues, screens, and main activity. All of have been built using Jetpack Compose. And then, of course, you need to have an activity. So you can consider all these things as view. And then you have view model. And here under this package, we have repository. So view model basically interacts with the repository. And then this repository interacts with the database, which is nothing but the model. So this is pretty classic MVVM architecture. So once you have understood that it is already built using MVVM architecture, now how are we going to refactor this particular code? We can get started either from Vue, or you can get started either from Model. What I will do is, I will prefer starting it from the bottom-up approach. We will first refactor the room database that is part of the model, and then we will refactor the repository, and then refactor the Vue model, and then, if necessary, even View. So we will take a bottom-up approach as far as the refactoring is concerned. So let's get started. So let me open the room database. You can see that I already have a defined function here, country DAO, which returns me a country DAO. Instead of that, what I will do is, I will make this particular function as part of some kind of a interface, because the whole reason why we are doing this is, we should be able to test this particular function later, and we will be able to do that if it is part of an interface. And if it is a part of interface, we will be satisfying the interface segregation principle and also dependency inversion principle, which basically states that the dependencies should be implemented through abstraction. To some extent, it is already abstract, but let's make it even more abstract by making it as a part of the interface. So what I will do is, I will create an interface here. Let me call that particular interface as database provider, and that particular interface will have this function country DAO, which returns a country DAO. And now going back to the app database, we will make this app database implement database provider. That basically means I will have to put override here, and then here I return database provider. And what is a database provider? It is an interface. So we are not dependent on the concrete implementation. Satisfied the dependency inversion principle, interface segregation principle by doing this. What we will also do is, we will probably create a package to separate out these things. It will make overall code much better. So let me create a package here, appdb, and move both of these things, that is app database and database provider, into appdb. Yeah, that's better. And now coming back to the country DAO, this itself is a interface. But once again, this interface is using these room database specific annotations. Someone might say that instead of directly relying on a room database provided interface, why not create our own interface and then extend that interface instead of directly relying on this DAO? That's perfectly fine. What we can do is, probably we will create another package here, call it as DAO. Move this particular DAO into this particular DAO package, and then here let me create another interface, iCountryDAO, and this thing will have some functions defined in it. Your country DAO extends iCountryDAO, and as soon as you do that, you will start getting a problem here, compilation error, hides the member supertype, needs override. That's not a problem. Let's just add override here, and that should take care of the issue. What is the issue? I think country update capital takes ID. So let me just update this particular code to make it compliant with the signature. Yeah, that should make it proper. And here IDAO delete only takes country. So let me go back here. This doesn't return int. So that's taken care. So now what we have done is, we have even made our country DAO interface extend another interface, which actually contains all these functions. Now let me go back to the repository. You can already see that there are some violations here. For example, instead of using country DAO, we can use iCountryDAO, because that is what the dependency inversion principle says. When you are passing the arguments, you should always ensure that it is not a concrete class. So now by using the interface, you are not only making it satisfy the dependency inversion principle, you are also making it satisfy the Liskov substitution principle, because any interface that implements this can be substituting here, and that will make it easy for testing because you can mock this by creating a mock country DAO. So now coming back to the country repository, you can see that there are already violations here. It is a concrete class. You cannot have a concrete class. So what I will do is to make it comply with the interface segregation principle and dependency inversion principle, I will create an interface with all these different methods and then make this country repository extend that interface. So let me go back here, repository, create a Kotlin interface. Let me call it as iCountry interface. And this will have these functions. And if you are wondering what is filter criteria, I will talk about it a bit later. So let me comment it out. And now coming back to the country repository, I will make this particular country repository extend iCountry repository. And then because I am implementing that particular interface, now these functions will have to write override. The repository has the filter countries. I think we will not be able to understand this without actually implementing the filter functionality. But for that, we will also have to understand what is this filter criteria. So this is a strategy pattern that I have implemented to make the filtering very much easy. Why, how, I will basically explain in the next video. So that's it in this particular video. It's a slow progress, but as we start refactoring our code, you will start understanding how the SOLID principles are getting applied to the various components. We have just applied it to the model part, which is the room database and the repository, and not even fully the repository. The filter is not yet implemented, but we will do that and much more in the upcoming videos. So stay tuned and let me know how you are finding this. Thanks for your time.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.